We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at The Batman Who Laughs, issue 1 of a 6-issue miniseries from 2018 from DC Comics. The storyline is called The Laughing House. This is part 1, obviously. Written by Scott Snyder. Art by Jock. Not Jocko, that was a guy in the 80s who sold Energizer batteries and was in a TV series called The Highwaymen. Different guy completely. David Barron did colors. Sal Cipriano letters. Jock did the cover. Greg Capullo, FCO Plasenia, did the variant cover. Dave Weiglos, assistant editor. Katie Kubert, editor. Jamie S. Rich, group editor. Now, this is one of the characters from Dark Knight's Metal, and I was afraid this would happen where they're going to wheel him out every so often and overuse him. If that character isn't killed by the end of this miniseries, I'm going to be really annoyed, because that's the problem DC has, is they overuse these characters. And it's very, very annoying. Because you get sick of seeing them. They're fine once in a while, but a character like this is going to be really overpowered, and they're just gonna use them over and over again. Then it becomes kind of a joke almost. You know, you can't take the storyline seriously because they overuse the character. Well, in this one, Batman is stopping some body smugglers, and he finds out who the body is inside, and he doesn't believe what he's seeing, so he has to look at it very carefully, and we learn it's not exactly what it seems, but it is who it seems. Then a Batman breaks into Arkham Asylum, kills a bunch of guards, almost kills Mr. Freeze, but it's not our Batman, but it's a Batman. And that's when we learn that there is in fact the Batman Who Laughs here, and Batman decides that he has to protect the Joker, but the Joker does something, and then Batman falls for what he even warned about halfway through the issue when he was talking to Gordon. So Batman acted kind of foolishly and recklessly here. Overall, it was an okay issue. It was fun. It was very dark, very moody, atmospheric, and very violent. So this is definitely not for younger readers. This is a more mature title. I liked it okay. I just thought the ending was a little bit silly and a little over the top. I hope they're not gonna have Batman be that silly. He was incredibly reckless if they do go with that. But overall, it was pretty good. Would I recommend it for $5? I don't know if I got $5 worth out of it. The art's solid. The writing's okay. Scott Snyder's a little ham-fisted sometimes, and this is pretty well written. I'm just worried that at the end he's gonna cheap out like he does sometimes. He's very mixed for me. I don't know if I really like a lot of his work. Some of it's good, but he seems to have trouble wrapping things up in a way that actually fits what happened in the story. We're gonna have to wait and see how it ends, but I'd recommend reading it. I just don't think it's worth $5. I wouldn't have felt ripped off. If it was $2.99 or $3.99, I would have been fine with it, but at $4.99, I think it's a little too expensive for a 6-issue miniseries. So if you can find it cheaper, definitely pick it up, but at $5, you really have to weigh how much you're really invested in this Joker Who Laughs character. But that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews, and we hope to see you on the next one.